Hey guys, thanks for watching. Welcome to my channel, Saumya's Bookstation. I'm Saumya. If you like my videos, please like and share them and subscribe to my channel. And please do not forget to press the bell icon so that every time I post a video, you get notified. So the winner of 2017 ManBooker Prize is Lincoln in the Bardo by George Saunders. I was actually really happy when I found out that Lincoln in the Bardo had won. Out of the 4 books that I had read from the 6 books in the shortlist, this was my favorite. Earlier I thought Elmet was my favorite, but that was before I had read Lincoln in the Bardo. In today's video, I'm going to talk about Lincoln in the Bardo by George Saunders. So let's get started. I have also reviewed this book on my blog. If you would like to check it out, I'll leave the link in the description box. Lincoln in the Bardo is a very unusual story and has been told in an extremely unique way. So this book combines both historical facts and fiction. So the son of Abraham Lincoln, 11-year-old Billy Lincoln, dies, and that leaves Abraham Lincoln completely heartbroken. So heartbroken that he visits the crypt of his son several times. And this happens in February 1862 during the time when American Civil War was going on. So President Lincoln has a lot of burden on his shoulders because of the war, as well as his son dies, so he's not in a very good situation. That is the historical truth in this book. The fiction begins when Billy Lincoln dies and enters into a state called the Bardo, which is the transitional state between rebirth and death. And here a lot of spirits are trapped, so Billy finds himself among so many spirits who are clamoring, who are arguing, talking to each other. So there's a lot of noise and he doesn't know what's happening and what's going on. This story takes place over a span of one night, where Billy spends his time here in the graveyard with all these spirits while his father Abraham Lincoln is mourning his death. These spirits do not know that they're dead and they have no idea who Abraham Lincoln is. They have no idea what is going on in the world. This story has been narrated by mainly three characters, who are three spirits who are trapped in the Bardo. One of them is Hans Wallman, another is Roger Bevins the third, and the third person is Reverend Everly Thomas. There are other spirits in the graveyard also, who come from time to time in the picture and they talk about their own lives in the previous place. And then there is Billy Lincoln, who is getting confused, who is having his own thoughts. Then there is Abraham Lincoln, who is having his own thoughts. And then there are people from the rest of the world making their comments on the death of Billy Lincoln, what they think about Abraham Lincoln's dealing with the American Civil War. So many things are happening in this book. So it takes a little getting used to the writing style in this book, but once you get used to it, this book is an utter delight to read. It is funny, it is thought-provoking. When a person speaks something, you see the dialogue that has been written, and below that dialogue you see the name of that person who spoke that dialogue. I'll just show you how this has been written. So as you can see, there are the dialogues, and below the dialogues you can see the name of the people who spoke those dialogues. So this book is like a series of hundreds of monologues, and this book also gives you a feeling like you're reading a play because of the way this has been written. The central theme of this book is the feeling of loss and familial love, because Abraham Lincoln loses his son, which leaves him really shattered. And there are times in this book when he is thinking to himself and he's reflecting on some really cruel truths of life, that how our stay in this world is only temporary and we have to let go, and how we have to move on. The way those reflections have been written is very moving. Along with that, there is Willie, who is trapped in the Bardo majorly because he sees his father coming to visit his crypt, and he is not able to leave that place because of his love for his father. That is very emotional to read as well. Racism is a very talked about issue in this book, because some of the spirits in the graveyard are black people and they share their experiences when they were alive. The way this transitional state between life and death has been imagined by George Saunders is really fascinating to read, with all these spirits clamoring with each other, arguing with each other. A lot of people are talking in this book, so it was like a lot of voices are speaking in my head, so that kind of threw me off guard from time to time. But I was able to come back very quickly and I was able to get engrossed just as quickly, and after that this book was a total worthwhile read, and I really enjoyed this book and I really love this book. This is such a wonderful book, and I was so happy when it won ManBooker 2017, and I highly recommend this book. My Goodreads rating for this book is 5 stars. If you want to get your hands on this book, then I'm going to leave the link to that in the description box. So these were my thoughts on this wonderful book by George Saunders. Do let me know in the comment section, have you read Lincoln in the Bardo already, or after this review, do you plan on reading it? I would love to know it. Please share your thoughts in the comment section, and I hope you found my review useful. If you want to connect with me on my social media, then the links are in the description box. I'll be back with my next video super soon. Bye!